Hanging out the sun roof. A little I-30, bro, it goes. Alright, put a little fucking shit on. Benny Mahoney. Yeah, mate, he's the number two in the division under Tim Zhu, and I'm the number three, so I think he's got some good boxing ability, but in this game, bro, it's fucking kill or be killed, you know. I go into shark mode, and when I sense blood in the water, that's like a scent for me that I just can't get my nose off, and I've just seen a few things, you know, like I've been calling him names on Instagram for like 2 years, and it's taken this long to accept the fight, so we'll see what those cracks look like in the ring, bro, you know, but it's going to be a fun fight, for sure. Like, I just think I'm a level above him, so, you know, I'm looking forward to finding out, but punch his moustache off his head and fucking end his porn star career. Nah, I'm sure he's a nice bloke. That's the thing, I don't even know him. Like, in this game, we live by a warrior's code, you know? We're like modern-day gladiators. That's what we do, bro. Hand-to-hand combat, we agree to fight upon a set of rules, see who's the best, by honour, all this shit. He stepped up to the challenge, see what happens, you know? If we're not trying to be better, pushing ourselves, challenging ourselves, getting the most out of it for ourselves and our family. Like, it's an awesome experience being able to do this stuff and surrounded by the best people doing it, having the best experiences. Enjoying the journey, I'm really enjoying the journey. It's awesome to reflect on it. There's two parts to me. It's one part I'm so humble and grateful and just happy to be here, just enjoying the journey. And the other part is fucking hungry demon wolf, bro. That's insatiable and coming for every single person that's in my spot. The story so far has been exciting outside of boxing as well, like having the mental health issues, having the fucking drug problems, getting as far as I can and having a story that I look back on and think, fuck, I really did as much as I could and I lived, you know, I lived. And having these little videos and these little like movies to encapsulate that and look back on and share with my family, and yeah, it fucking gets the juices flowing, that's for sure. Bro, a more fatty, bro, that's what this is, a more fatty, love of one's fate. To take everything that happens as good or at least necessary. Whatever happens, I'm happy, but yeah, I want it all. Dad and Rodney have been in my corner every single one of my fights. Outside of that, for the 12 years I've been boxing and the 90 plus fights I've had, they've been there the whole way. And yeah, man, they've seen all the ups and downs. Such a great relationship, man. I'm very, very lucky. With all that, I've got Mia as well, my strength conditioning coach. I was his first client at Ethos, and that's what gets us through those tight, hard parts of a fight all the time. And yeah, my missus, bro, again, we've been together for 12 years. We've been together since we were kids. We've had our hiccups and our shit, but we've now got a beautiful house together, two beautiful children, engaged to be married. And yeah, man, she's my peaceful and quiet and calm. And those hard times, like those periods of me, like, really crashing and cracking, like she was, and I could never thank her enough, like raising my children, providing for our family and supporting my career. She's an amazing person, and yeah, like this is really a team thing, but it's why it's Team Mazoudier. It's Team Mazoudier. It's Colin Mazoudier leading the charge. I'm in there fighting behind us, you know, my family, those people that have been there for 12 plus years are the ones that are like the closest and the most important. But we just kept striving and believing, and it's something that I like reflect on again. He's like, what is, like, I'm not even sure what it is that like I have this like fire in me, but this undying belief in myself to be able to do whatever I want, but to be able to achieve this in this sport specifically, to be able to go become a world champion and to go as far as I possibly can in this sport. And it's just these little lessons and things you take away about having the right people around you, surrounding yourself with a good diet, like, which is good people, good information, as well as like good food and exercise and all that shit, the right people. It seems to be the recipe and it's working at the moment. My career, you know, like I feel like I'm ticking all the boxes. I feel like I'm fitter than I've ever been. The future to look forward to, as well as the present sort of, and the past pushing me forward.
All of the fighters on the pay-per-view in a beautiful part of Sydney on a fantastic day.
Yeah, a little bit. Only because I've just, you know, it's not that I don't believe in him. I think he's a good fighter too, but I've just seen his lack of belief in himself, you know, and his choice of fights and knowing he's turned down big money fights and big opportunities in the past, you know. Like, I see some insecurities there, you know. Like, I'm a shark in water when it comes to fighting. So when I smell blood, it's time for the kill, and that's all I can see. It's just a bit of banter, mate. Doesn't even want to look at me right now, so it is what it is. His fight promotion, his fight night, two different things, so I couldn't care what the words are. I said, I'm going to punch his head in on Sunday, and that's it.
for the fans. And, you know, like, I'm in this for two reasons. It's to prove myself against the best possible test I can find. I've shown that in chasing the hardest fights in Australia, and I continue to do that. And the other reason is to entertain and to put on a show. I'm sure on the night we'll get along.
I'll tell you a story. I'll tell you a little story of where we are. The Opera House right there, one of the most famous buildings in Sydney, obviously. In a fight, one of the trainers pulling the fighter over the back and grabbing him, and then one of the other trainers running across and fly kicking the other opponent. Basically, all in brawling shoot. That was had Johnny Lewis and had a bunch of Australian people in it. All out brawling shoot in the Opera House, people falling over the rafters and shit go. But at least we get to have a look out while we do the press. Good luck, eh?
Thank you very much, mate. Likewise.
Cheers, bro. Appreciate it. Jason, you fucking big monkey. Look at that. All right. But the first, like, 2-3 rounds were perfect.
Yeah, I know. I just fucking went this shit. I've already copped the spray.
I can imagine, bro. I was getting rid of the text. I was watching on delay.
Yeah.
So it already happened. I was, like, after, like, 3 rounds, I was literally getting my phone out, be like, Joel, fucking beautiful performance.
Yeah, and then he would have just gave up, like, you know.
He would have not been done, you know, 4 rounds down or whatever.
Yeah. But
oh, bro, cracker of a fight. Yeah, it was the best fight on the card.
Yeah.
Fuck you, I saw you on Dolce & Gabbana the other day, whatever you're on.
Whatever, I fucking go get some drip.
Yeah, fuck you.
Nah, they're not giving that much.
Yeah, I'm not complaining. Like, I had nothing until 4 or 5 fights ago. And these shows, that's all we got to do, bro. Like, at least the door's all there now. He's got
to
win.
Nah, you don't need to, don't do it. I have to.
Yeah, but I got to look professional. Like, no one wants to talk to me, man. I got to do something, you know what I mean? So I was going to go the 3-piece suit, go fancy, but next one, I think.
Yeah, sweet.
We're not in the sun.
Oh, well, mate, I tell you, if you win the fight first and then worry about your suit.
After
deals.
Shit, exactly, yeah.
For sure.
Yeah, no, appreciate it, bro. I'll see you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow. Thanks, mate. Yeah.
Oh, holy fuck, bro. I'm sweating my balls off. He got ice cream with my coach the other day, I think.
Was that your coach?
Yeah.
He took us. Yeah,
appreciate that.
Yeah. Good to meet you, too.
Yeah, you too, man.
Thank you. Are you doing the commentary for the...
working with Fox, yeah.
The main card only,
the main
do you know?
Card, I'm going to be doing three of the main card fights. Yep. Cool. Early in the night.
I'm on the main of the prelims.
Okay.
Please, my man.
See if they can let me on.
Brother, please.
You got the two highest ranked super welterweights in the country, other than Tim.
Mm. Yeah.
Mad fight. And like I said, when we announced it, when we got it done, I was like...
Yeah, mate, it's a good fight. Won't buy it.
No, well, I liked what you had to say out there. I thought that was mad.
It is what it is, bro.
It's good.
That's what
I know you always deliver too. When you talk, you deliver.
Yeah, man. I wanted to have a bit of banter and build it up because, like, it's an exciting, as a fan of boxing, I'm like, this is an exciting fight. And, like, you didn't want to do it. It is what it is. All right, enjoy. We'll see you then. I'm feeling better. Yeah. You say shit that don't matter. Yeah. She wanna fuck with letter. Gang. So, on today's episode of How to Change a Fucking Car Wheel, we've had a blown tire on the way out of the press conference, which is great, because I wasn't dying of heat stroke or anything in that fucking sun. And I love doing this sort of stuff. It's my favorite activity. My muscles look good at least. Look at me go lifting a car. Just fuming doing this shit. So it could be worse, I guess.
Why you bring that money to the club if you ain't done? And from right here in Sydney, please welcome Cohen Mazoudier. Yeah. 13 fights, 11 wins, 4 stoppages, 2 losses. Kilograms, Mazoudier. Let's hear it for this one. It is Cohen Mazoudier and Ben Mahoney.
That was a good feeling, good show. Eyes were fucking moving, he wouldn't keep his eyes still. I said to him, I see some fear in those eyes. I said, he's scared of losing. He said, nah, I'm not scared. You've already lost. I said, yeah, but that's why I'm not scared. But definitely saw a little crack there, so keen to explore it tomorrow. Feel good, fresh. Got cryo booked the Savo, so go do a bit of cold therapy, chill out, bit of PlayStation, and then go to war tomorrow. Showtime, nice and quiet at the moment. It'll fill up soon though. Not sure how many people will be here when I fight, but there should be about 15,000 or so, I reckon, by the time it's full, 10 to 15. So, gonna be a good night. Got a decent sleep last night. Ready to bang on.
rush, you ought to see this. Turn up the lights in here, baby. You know what I need, want you to see everything. Want you to see all of the lights. Fast cars, shooting stars. All of the lights, all of the lights.
Injuries, illnesses, medications, nothing. This is how we ended up on the footy show.
Yeah, you told me.
Don't go to shake my hand now, all right? Look, I've done it.
Yeah, I'm Dean, Cohen's dad. Mate, I've been training Cohen since he was about 13, I imagine. He came to me and said he wanted to do some form of combat sport, which was really odd because he was a very placid kid and I didn't really figure he was going to do that type of thing. I took him somewhere I knew he'd get good coaching. He's moved along a lot, obviously. I'm really proud of what he's done with himself. He didn't have to stick with it. A lot of kids don't stick with boxing. Cohen stuck with it. And I've always said, if you stick with boxing, you can go places, but you've got to stick with it. Happy with where he's at. Got his head in a good place. I think he can win this fight, I really do. Take any easy fights. Cohen stipulated that early on. He doesn't want any easy fights. He wants to go places. So that's our aim. And onward, never upward.
My name's Brad, came really, really close mates probably about 10 years ago. Through his journey, like so far out, couldn't be more proud, like as a mate in general, he's just been the one that's like consistently shown up and just kept pushing and just like exploring himself more to develop himself to become that world-class fighter that he sees himself as and we all can see him as. As he starts getting those opportunities, he's going to walk through them or learn from them and come back and smash them. Inevitably, like the big names, like he'll get to the zoos and get on the world-class as well, which I'm pretty confident in. Yeah, bro, to see him like go through his battles like with mental health and like come out of that completely strong, where that's like been a situation where you'd see that crush a lot of people. Very proud to call my mate to see him be able to like overcome that and not only overcome it but turn it into like a superpower. And now that's like something that really, really serves him. Yeah, I'm excited to see where his career goes and really.
Yeah, well, here we are, 12th of March, day's arrived, probably the best preparation thus far. People are gonna be happy with what they see come fight time. Cohen's been with me for a very long time now. Boxing's an up and down game. It's not just one smooth sail to the top like everyone thinks. But, you know, seeing Cohen do the ups and downs, probably his biggest down was the night of the first Wade Ryan fight. But without a doubt and most definitely, we've got the polar opposite of that tonight. So I'm looking forward to what he's going to produce against Ben Mahoney. And yeah, it's going to be a good fight.
When you're at band camp, thinking the crap can't happen. Till you fuck around, get in
talking and you stand back gasping. Fucking assassins hijacking Amtrak's crashing. All this terror, America demands action. Next thing you know, you got Uncle Sam's ass asking to join the army or what you do for that Navy. You just a baby getting recruited at 18. You're on a plane now eating their food and their baked beans. I'm 28, they gon' take you for they take me. Crazy insane or insane crazy? When I say Hussein, you say shady. My views ain't changed till inhumane. Wait, arraign two
days. Move that fight up. Like, fuck, if anyone watched that, that's a world-class fight. We should be fighting a main event. So, yeah, we'll do it again. I'll fight tomorrow. I'll fight him again tomorrow. 12 rounds. He won't survive 12 rounds if we did it. Yeah, mate, Blacktown 2140. That's what we represent, you know. But I'm trying to show that you can do anything from anywhere. So it doesn't matter who you are, where you're from, you can do whatever. So I appreciate everyone that came out.
Nothing moves me more than a groove that soothes me. Nothing soothes me more than a groove that boosts me. Nothing boosts me more, suits me beautifully. There's nothing you can do to me, stab me.
The main quest of world class level fight. I'm disappointed because I didn't come here for anything less than victory, but we'll do it again. I'll do it tomorrow in about 5 minutes if you have to.
He mentions
the Gold Coast,
when you go there.
Yeah, fuck him anywhere, anytime. I've heard it anytime.
Yeah, no, I need to look for something. Mm. But then what happens is you get caught out, not you looking and you're not throwing.
Yeah.
So it's not bad to look for stuff, but if we look for stuff with the idea that this is what could happen, I'm looking for stuff. I've got to be conscious of that while I'm looking for stuff.
I'm not just looking for stuff.
And,
like 6, 7 or whatever. That's when I started actually leading him. Doing it, waiting.
Nah, brother, that's bullshit. Fucking
blow
my ass.
As I say, not good enough, bro. Didn't do enough, but.
You're busy. He's on the bed. You don't fucking score points for making some cunt miss. Doing that shit, looking like fucking.
We're just saying, when I was on the front foot, I was doing alright.
You
hit
me with the left hook in the ninth, big time.
I had two bad periods. I had two fucking bad periods, and those flat shots, I like it.
Yeah.
I'm fucking pissed off, bro. But it is what it is, bro. Go do it again.
Go to the fucking Gold Coast and steamroll the
cunt. Yeah, fuck my butt. You go get this coming out.
Easy, go.
Hotel, I booked a shit hotel, so it's just little bits to fix each time.
Yeah.
Learn how to box better, prepare better. Team put in so much effort that I'm very frustrated. I thought I won the fight. Draw, participation award, not what I came here for. Apologies to everyone that's part of the team and puts all the effort in with me. We put in too much effort and hard work for a draw, but it is what it is. I thought I did enough to win the fight, but I didn't do enough as much as I could to dominate and really make my own. So we keep the title, keep the belt, I'll keep my world ranking. But yeah, I'm not happy with that. That's a loss in my book in regards to decision-wise, but it is what it is. We'll come back, we'll have a rematch, you know. Hopefully, it's very soon, hopefully. Hopefully I'll have a rematch soon and submit my top at the number one spot. So, appreciate everyone's support, all my sponsors, Taipan Solutions, Life to Battlefield, Blends and Brothers, UPS Solutions, Calm Palm, John, thank you, brother. All the other guys, Elevate Health, and all my subs and Mrs. Brianna, thank you very much. Love you very much. You've done so much for me this camp. Big thank you to Nathan, Unbroken. You've done so much for me, mate. Like, awesome shirts, you know, helping me all the time. I really appreciate you. My coaches, my team, Rodney Williams, the hours we put in. Thank you very much. Dad, Mum, Mir, Strength, you know, Ethos, Performance, everyone involved. We couldn't do it without anyone. So thank you to everyone that's come along and then been a part of the journey. We ain't stopping. This ain't fucking the end at all. This ain't the end at all. This is just the beginning. As I said, I'll get better with each round as we saw in that fight, as we saw in the last rematch that I had. So we'll have a rematch with this bloke ASAP. He said Gold Coast. I said fucking his mum's kitchen if we have to, I don't care. So yeah, we'll get that one back soon. Thank you, everyone.